Flipside, everybody. I'm Michael Loftus. Now, we've only got a teeny weeny bit of time left for the Obama administration, and we are going to make it. Looks like we made it. There's gonna be a bunch of cleaning up to do after he's gone, but we can do it. Back in the day, Jimmy Carter almost crushed us, but then we got Ronnie Reagan and a bunch of sweet, sweet years, and we're just gonna have to do something like that again. Can we do it? Yes, we can. Because we're Americans and we're smarter than these idiots who think they're smarter than us. Ha! Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Now, Barack Obama knows exactly what he's doing. Now, at least he told the truth right before Election Day in 2008. Barack stood in front of everybody and he said this: "We are 5 days away from fundamentally transforming the United States of America." Yeah, and you know what? He wasn't lying. Everybody thought it was just like political blah, 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 hope and change, but that dude was for real. He was literally trying to transform the United States of America. Why would you want to do that? If you love something, you don't want to fundamentally change it. If the United States of America was a house, it would not be a teardown, okay? You wouldn't bulldoze it and just start over. If anything, we're a fixer-upper. Every once in a while, we need some new shutters, clean the gutters, and let's do something about that carpet, because it doesn't go with anything. I don't think you could find anyone else in history who was so uniquely unqualified to be the president of the United States. Barack's big claim to fame is that he was a community organizer in Chicago. Community organizer is one step away from professional babysitter. Now, here's a dude whose mentor was Franklin Marshall Davis, a card-carrying member of the Communist Party. Why do I say that? Because Davis literally carried a Communist Party USA membership card, number 47544. Bing it up on the interwebs. It's all there. Sorry, Google. You know I love you. But every once in a while, I just gotta say Bing, right? Obama began his political career with a fundraiser in Bill Ayers' living room. Bill Ayers, founder of the Weathermen, a little group of free thinkers who bombed the Pentagon, the U.S. Capitol, and NYPD headquarters in the 1970s. It's there. Look it up. Bing, Bing, Google, Bing. Our president hung out with communists and terrorists. Somebody give this man a peace prize. Yeah, they did, the Nobel Peace Prize. If it was a movie, you wouldn't believe it. You'd be like, this is stupid. This could never happen in real life. I mean, no one thinks he's the bad guy? Let's go watch something else. I like Transformers. Seriously, it's like a nightmare. But guess what? Nightmares are just bad dreams, and they all come to an end. And this one, almost over. When people complain about Congress being slow and dragging their feet, I'm like, yay! Good for you, Congress! Slow it down! Dragging good! I feel like we should possibly debate this subject for, 2 years? I don't know who that guy is, but I'm voting for him. One day, very soon, and that day is coming, we will all look back and say, wow, remember back in 2008? When America elected Barack Obama president, that was crazy. Obamacare, that was like a thing for a second until people realized it was so jacked up, we went back to the way things were before when you could actually keep your own doctor. Look it up, bing! Jeremiah Wright, bing, bing, Google, bing! Apology tour, bing, bing, Google, bing! Benghazi, bing, bing, Google, bing! Let me hear you say it. I can't believe you did it! So congratulations, America, we're almost done. Looks like we made it. This is the flip side. We got a lot more shows. Stick around, it's gonna be fun. We'll be right back.
Questions without answers. If Islam is a religion of peace, wouldn't its extremists be extremely peaceful?